Now, there are a lot of different variables that can make or break how well your stock vehicle can off-road. And after renting a bone stock Jeep Wrangler Unlimited for the Great Smoky Mountain Tennessee Jeep Invasion, we answer the question of, is a stock Jeep Wrangler really that capable off-road? Well, let's go find out. First off, the Wrangler Unlimited is a four-door version of Jeep's iconic Wrangler that has literally been around since the 50s. Although the Wrangler name didn't appear until the 1987 model year when it made its debut as a replacement for the Jeep CJ. The Unlimited name first appeared on a longer wheelbase version of the two-door 2004 Wrangler, but the four-door version didn't appear until the 06 model year. With the same rugged, distinctive retro look and similar off-road capabilities, the five-seat Wrangler Unlimited offers a longer wheelbase for easier rear seat access and more room once you're back there. A 2018 redesign, also known as a JLU, as most Jeep will refer to them as, addressed many of the JKU Wrangler drawbacks, improving on-road handling and ride comfort while bringing a quieter, more civilized interior and added technology features. Regardless of the vehicle, a large percentage of your off-roading success comes from experience. In so many different off-roading scenarios, we have seen bone stock 4x4s outwheel even some of the more heavily modified vehicles. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm a huge proponent of modifying an off-road vehicle, well, especially since we sell all different types of wheel and tire packages, suspension systems, and accessories on our Trailbuilt Off-Road website, but there is probably no better mod that you can do to your rig than just getting some good old seat time. Then combine that with an experienced spotter to walk you through some of the challenges and precarious spots out on the trail, and there's a good chance you can get your stock Jeep on factory tires with street air pressures in the tires through just about anything you encounter out on the trails. While we were in Pigeon Forge, Tennessee, we had met up with some friends to finally be able to really get to test out our bone stock Wrangler Sport and hit the trails near the abandoned Nemo train tunnel. With 35 pounds of air pressure in each Goodyear Wrangler tire, which was basically just a road tire more than it was an all-terrain, and Zach, our videographer behind the wheel, with Nick, our operations lead, providing all the spotting, we were able to navigate the trails even better than some of the other mildly built rigs that were out on the trails that day. And by no means is that bragging or puffing out our chest in pride or anything like that, but when you know exactly where to place the tires on which rock at a specific time, along with just the right amount of throttle, not to mention the capability of the Jeep platform, you are able to get even a stock Jeep through just about anything. Now, with that said, a stock Wrangler still has its limits on the more extreme trails and obstacles, and that's where heading to our website for some more aggressive off-road tires, a suspension lift and a winch and set of recovery bumpers will take your Jeep to that next level of off-road capability. But remember that gaining the experience of learning how to off-road a stock vehicle first will be more valuable and pay off in dividends over the long run than even the most expensive upgrade can. So even with the extended wheelbase of the Wrangler Unlimiteds compared to their two-door counterpart, street tires with street air pressure, and just being basically a base model Wrangler and not even a Rubicon, a stock Jeep Wrangler with an experienced driver and a capable spotter can do really well off-road and tackle more than we expected anyways. So to answer the question of, is the Jeep Wrangler really that capable off-road? Well, from our experience, the answer is yes. They really are quite capable vehicles as they were originally meant to be. And guys, this was just some of our personal experiences with a stock Jeep Wrangler, but make sure and let us know some of your guys' personal experiences with stock vehicles, and if you think a stock vehicle with an experienced driver and spotter is just as capable as a modified off-road vehicle with a less experienced driver behind the wheel and no spotter. Definitely make sure and let us know in the comments below. Other than that, guys, if you liked today's video, hit that thumbs up, and to stay up to date with all of our videos, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the little bell next to it. As always, guys, we appreciate all of you for watching and all of your support. I'm Josh from Trailbuilt, and we'll see you guys out on the trails.